गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। वेट वेट, स्टिल योर फ्रेंड्स आर जॉइनिंग
सर।
Yuvraj, what is our last term? Wait on.
Sir, we have done. Sir, we have done how to express a recurring statement into a form.
Yuvraj, so Harsha, your voice is not proper. Yuvraj, you read.
Yes, sir. Sir, the PQ form of 0.67 is dash.
0.67 we did. Did we found for 0.35?
Yes. No, sir. 0.375 we got.
How many sums we did based on that? So convert into P by Q form. How many sums we did?
Four.
Sir, we did five.
Which are the numbers I given?
Sir, first one 0.6.
0.6 repeated, na? 6 bar.
Yes, sir.
For second one?
0.35
bar. 35
bar.
Next to third one?
0.675.
Harsha, you silence because your voice is not proper. So I will ask
sir,
you a question.
Fourth one 0.375.
375.
Fifth one? Sir, that's it.
That's it only?
Sir.
Only this much we did?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Harsha?
Yes, sir.
So how many numbers we did? Okay. So mute your audio. Still 5 minutes are there, right? Your friends are joining still.
Sir, now you can hear my voice clearly, sir.
Wow.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Sir, message.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Tell me.
Sir, what happens? What do we do when we have three recurring decimals, sir? How to do that?
One more time.
What happens when we get three recurring decimals? How can we express in P by Q form?
You multiply by 1000.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
It is very simple, Arsha. Say, yeah. So if x is equal to 0.666666, you can write this as 0.6 bar, you know.
Yes, sir.
So what is the p by q for me? So x is equal to, so whichever repeating digit you write, 6 divided by. So if one is repeated, only one line will come. So you can divide 3 2s are 3 3s are 2 by 3. First one, second one. So if x is equal to 0.3333, so you can write as 0.3 bar. So x is equal to, how many digits are there? Is that correct?
Sir, 3 5, sir.
No, no, only if you take only 3, 0.3333, how you can express as P by Q me? I will tell you shortcut method. So which digit is repeating, which digits are repeating? 3 is repeating, you know? So only 3 is repeating. So that is called as only 1 is repeating, right? 9. So if two repeating terms will come, x is equal to 0.3535, so on. So you can divide it. 3 1s are 3 3s are 1 by 3 is the answer. So I am telling you shortcut method. So 0.35, you can write 0.35 bar. So then next is equal to, how many digits are repeating?
So
two, which are those? 3 5, you know, 3 5 divided by, if one digit will repeat, you divide by 9. If two digit will repeat, you divide by 2 9 9 9. So if three digit will repeat, you write 9 9 9.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So next up.
Sir, we should we copy this?
If you want, you can copy. Shortcut method it is. If only 0 point will come, if any other numbers will come, so it is different. I will tell you.
Okay, sir.
You can copy this. Understood, you are how to go with shortcut method?
Sir, I did not ask.
See here. So if one digit will repeat, take the digit, divide by 9, 1 line. So here also, one digit is repeating, take the digit, 3 is repeating, 3 by 9. If two digit will repeat, 0.353535, take those two digits and divide by double 9. Why we take a double 9, you ask?
Sir, because two digits are there.
Yeah. Two digits should be paid. So if nothing, and you should remember, nothing should be there because of digit. Only 0 point should come. So 0.35 bar we can write as 35 divided by 99. So one digit is repeating, 3 divided by 9. One digit is repeating, take that digit divided by 9. So now how you can find x s? The fourth one I will tell you. So if x is equal to 0.67 bar. How you can write it 3/24?
Sir, we can write it as 67/99.
Very good. That's it. Two digits are repeating. You write 67/9.
Oh, sir, I didn't understand this one.
See, so if they given the x is equal to 0.6 bar, only one digit is repeating. So take the digit divided by 9. One line.
Okay.
So here also only one digit is repeating. Take the digit divided by 9. But in case of two digits, so if two digits are repeating, 3535, 3535. Take the 3/5 divided by 99.
Okay, sir.
If one digit is repeating, divide by 1/9. If two digits are repeating, divide by 99. If three digits are repeating, you should divide by 999. So for example, so this is fourth one, you know, sixth one. So if it is 0.916 bar. X is equal to 0.916 bar. How you can write this?
916/999.
Very good. That's it only. 916/999. If one digit is repeating, take the digit divided by 9. If it is cancelling, you should cancel. Yes, it is cancelling. 6 2 is 6, 3 is 3. So 2/3. So here also only one digit is repeating. Take that digit divided by 9. This shortcut method. So we are going to use this only for if, so only 0. So only 0.6 repeated 6 bar 0.35. If anything is there with that, we can't use that. Like if the numbers are like this only, we can use. So here two digits are repeating. 0.353535. Take those two digits and divide by 29. If two digits should repeat, you divide by 29. If three digits should repeat, you divide by 39. If four digits should repeat,
49.
Very simple it is. Shortcut method. If you want, you can copy.
Yes, sir. Very easy. Sir, what happens when we get 1.6 bar?
1.6 bar is there. There also you can get. So only one digit is repeating. Is that right? 16/9. So you are asking 1.6, okay? So next one, sixth one, So if x is equal to, you are asking 1.6 bar. Okay, so therefore x is equal to, so take 10 into, so this is 10 this year, divided by 9 only. You can write this as 1.66666, you know. So only one digit is repeating. Write that one as it is. One. 6 divided by 9, 16/9 you are getting. If you divide, you are getting same thing. Check once. Okay, I will start now. So if how you can write x is equal to 23.43 bar converted to p by q form in shortcut method?
Sir, it's 2.343 by
23.43 like this is expanding. So x is equal to, you write the 23 as it is. And next you write 43 divided by how many digits are repeating?
Sir, two.
Two.
Two digits divided by double nine. Understood?
Sir, what about the point, sir?
So if you like this, it is coming. For example, I will tell you. 5.6723. If only 2, 3 are repeating, you can't use this step. Okay, so which is the point? So along with the party here, with the point, so after point, so only repeating digit should be there to apply this. So for this we can't able to apply. If you see here, the non-repeating digits are there, 6, 7. For this you can't use this method. So after point only repeated digits will come, then only you can use this method. So if non-repeating digits will come, you can't use this method. Shortcut method you can't use. You should multiply by 100. Okay, you are getting actually 6. So 567 divided by double nine. I will tell you. Okay. This is the way to do in shortcut method. Shall I ask? Are you copying?
Sir, copying 1 minute.
Okay, copy.
So done.
These are the shortcut methods.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Tell me.
Sir, in the 7th question, you did 2, 3, 4, 3 by 99.
Hmm.
But where is the point, sir?
After dividing, you will get. If you want, you can divide. 23 by double nine. It's definitely you are getting 23.434343 only. Point will not come. We cancel the point. So canceling the point only, we are doing those all. Multiply by 100, multiply by 1000.
Okay, sir.
Point will not come. We are going to write in p by purely p by q form.
Okay, sir. Sir, done.
Oh, okay. So next question you write. Question number 5, I think. So the p by q form of option A 2 by 15, Option D, 15 by 11. Option C, 3 by 20. Option D, 3 by 4. This is not repeating. It is terminated. Terminated 0.15 only. So x is equal to 0.15. So is equal to 15 divided by 100. So you can write as 3 by 20. It is the previous year question, sir. Question, okay? Three by 20 is the answer. Option C.
Done, sir.
Okay. Copy it, all of you. Still yes, anybody copying? You can raise your hands if anybody are copying. Rajwal? Okay, sir. Copy. I will give time, don't worry. So much time is there, we can finish the syllabus. You can copy, but you should understand, okay? Understand the concept. Next question. You right? Question number 6. In a division question, in a division question, the denominator is 10 times to its quotient, so this is question. In a division question, the denominator is 10 times to its quotient, and 5 times so its remainder. accordingly if the remainder is 46, what will be the dividend? What will be the dividend? Dividend. Option A. Dividend. Option A. 4236. Option B. 4306. Option C. 4336. Option D. 5336. So once again I will repeat. So you know that in division only, so those four components will come. In division, we are getting four components: dividend, divisor, quotient, and remainder. You know the relation between those. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, according to that, we should do this. So in a division question, the denominator is 10 times to its quotient and 5 times to its remainder. Accordingly, if the remainder is 46, what will be the dividend? They ask you. Copy the question.
Yes, sir.
Anybody are copying same? Raise your hand.
Copied.
Copied. Okay. So I will go for working. Okay. So your the given divisor is 5 times of remainder. Because remainder value is given, you take part of that only. So divisor is equal to 5 times of remainder is equal to 5 into 46. 5 into 46 is 230. So they are given divisor is equal to 5 times of remainder. So the division question, the denominator is 10 times of its quotient. Oh, so the denominator means divisor only, you know. So you can write, so in question, you can write somewhere, denominator means divisor only. So I will write. Denominator means because you will confuse why we are taken divisor. Denominator means divisor only. Okay, so all that is related. So the divisor is equal to divisor or denominator is equal to five times of remainder. So these are not need to write. So you just go for solving. Okay. So not need to write in exam. Here you can write for your understanding. So 5 into what is the value of remainder is 46. 46 is the we found 230. Again, how the denominator so linked with quotient, related with quotient, the same divisor is 10 times of quotient. 10 times of quotient. Quotient. Already we found the divisor. Divisor is 230. So in the place of divisor, if you put 230, you can get quotient. So in the place of divisor, you put 230 is equal to 10 into quotient. Cross multiply this 10. So what you will get? So quotient is equal to 230 by 10. 00 it cancels is equal to 23. We found divisor as 230. From the second relation, we found quotient. So we had remainder is there, quotient is there, divisor is there. You can easily find dividend by using division formula. So I will repeat once again. In the division question, the denominator means divisor only. So I will write you here 5/6. So what is the denominator?
6.
Six is the divisor, you know. This six. Part is dividend. We are going to divide 5/6, you know. So 6 is called as divisor. So in a division question, the denominator means divisor only. The divisor is 10 times to its quotient. 10 times to its quotient. And 5 times to its remainder. 5 times to its remainder. So accordingly, if the remainder is given, why I taken first? This only means this value is given. Remainder. 5 into remainder. 5 times of remainder. Accordingly, if the remainder is 46, what will be the dividend? So, understand the given statement. So, take in mathematical form. So, divisor is equal to 5 times of remainder. Remainder value is given, 46. 5 into 46 is 230. So, one more relation is given. The divisor or denominator is 10 times of quotient. We already found divisor as 230. In the place of divisor, you put 230. So 10 into quotient. Cross multiply 10. You are getting quotient is equal to 23 by 10. 00 get cancelled. Quotient is equal to 23. You know the dividend formula. So dividend is equal to divisor into quotient. Shall I write that side? See here, I will write here. Otherwise, if you copied the question, I will rub the question. So you know the formula for dividend. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient. Less reminder. So is equal to divisor. We found divisor is. So we found 230 into quotient. We found 23. The given value of the remainder is plus 46. So multiply 230, 23 is a and add 46, that is only the dividend. So just you send the message, don't tell the answer. Multiply 230, 23 is down and add 46. Send the message, don't tell the answer. If you found the answer, send message. Multiply 230, 23 is down. Very good, Bharata. Very good, Asya. Good, good. Multiply 230 into 23 and add 46. What is the answer you will get? Send through the message. Bhargavaram and Asya did. So by multiplying this, so you are getting 5290 plus 46. 5290 plus 46 is 5336. Then answer is option D. Answer option D, 5336. One more time I will repeat. They given how the denominator, that means denominator is divisor only. How the divisor is related with remainder and quotient. So the denominator is 5 times of remainder. The divisor is 10 times of quotient. So they given value of remainder. So that only you take this first. Divisor is equal to 5 times of remainder. 5 into remainder is 46. By multiplying these two, you are getting 230. And divisor is 10 times of quotient. Already you found divisor there, 230. Substitute in the place of divisor 230 into 10. We don't know quotient. We need to find quotient, right? Quotient as it is. So cross multiply 10. You are getting quotient is equal to 230 by 10. So 0, 0 get cancelled. Quotient is 23. You know the division formula. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Substitute there. You will get the answer. Very, very simple it is. Understood, yes, all of you?
Yes, sir, understood. Done.
Archa, you please keep quiet. I am asking others. Mute your voice, mute your audio, okay? So if anybody has any doubt, please ask. Raise your hand. Very, very easy sum. They given in question only. They given these two in question. By taking those two, we found divisor and quotient. If only anybody has any doubt, please ask. Rohit, understood? Rohit? Mr. Rohit, understood? Rohit,
yes, sir.
Then yes, why sir. You not answer? Why you not send the answer?
Sir, network problem.
Sanjay? Understood, Sanjay?
I understand, sir.
Oh, then why you not send the answer? You should multiply and add, you know. Hitesh, Keshav Prajwal, Prajwal left Chandan.
Yes, sir.
Sukhit, why you not
understood,
send the answer?
Sir.
Vishwanath?
Yes, sir.
You should send answer, okay?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yuraj, yes, sir. You should be active, okay? You should send the answer. You multiply and send the answer.
Sir, actually I was writing.
Okay. Next we go for second question. Next question. What is the question number? Raksha, what is the question number for?
Sir,
question number 7.
7. You write how many 1/6 apostrophe s 1/6 together make the number forty one two by three mixed fraction 41 2/3. Option A 125. Option B. Option B 150. Option C 250. Option D 350. Understood the question? Like this, they will ask, they choose the question.
Yes, sir, we understood the question.
So, see here, I will explain one more time how it is mean. How many twos together make four? How many twos together make four? How many twos we should add to make four?
Two. Okay.
Two into two is equal to four. Two twos should be necessary to make four. How many threes should be necessary to make 60? How many threes should be necessary to make 60?
20.
How you can get? So divide by 3 to 60. Divide 60 by 3, you are getting 20. Okay, so how many 4 should be necessary? How many 4 should be necessary to make the number 120.
30.
30. How you can get? By dividing this. Okay, 20 by 4, you are getting 430 is the. So 4 into 30 is equal to 120. So that's why we need 34 to make 120. We need 34 to make 120. So here, 60 by 3, 3 ones are 320 is the. So that's why 3 into 20 is equal to 60. So we need 23 to make 60. So say like that only, but here they taken fraction. Okay, they taken only fraction. So that means you should divide 41 2 by 3 by 1 by 6. You will get the answer. Very, very simple it is. Working. So you divide 41 2 by 3 by 1 by 6. So convert into improper fraction. 41 3 is 41 into 3 plus 2 divided by 3 divided by 1 by 6. So 41 3 is 123 plus 2. 123 plus 2 is 125. Divided by 3 by 1 by 6. Okay. So to change the divided symbol into into, you should take reciprocal. I told you already. Division of fractions. So therefore, 125, you put is equal to, sorry. So is equal to 125. Divided by 3 into 6 by 1. You should take reciprocal of this. So change into 2 divided by 2 into. Take the reciprocal of this. 3 1s are, 3 2s are. So 125 2s are. You are getting 125 into 2 is equal to 250. And what is the right answer?
Let's see.
Answer is Next. I think all are copied. If anybody are copying, raise your hand.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Tell me.
This sum only, sir.
Ah.
You took reciprocal, reciprocal, no, sir?
Ah.
After, in the right side, 125 by 3 into 6 by 1, no? How you did, sir?
See, what symbol it is?
This, division.
Divided by symbol, okay? To convert into, we are going to multiply that. Okay? To convert into multiplication, you should take reciprocal of the divisor. This is called as divisor. See, after writing into.
Okay, sir.
So we are changing division to multiplication. But this is the rule. Oh, Yashraj, is it Yashraj?
Keshav, sir.
Keshav. So, to convert division into multiplication, you should take reciprocal of the divisor. If 1 by 6 is there, you should take 6 by 1. If 2 by 3 is there, you take 3 by 2. Okay? To
okay,
change
sir.
Divided by 2 into. To change divided by 2 into. You should use that. So, mute your audio. Yes, sir. Still anybody are copying? I'm going to Rob. Please raise your hand. Okay. Sorry, Rob. Still you are writing? Rajwan?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Right. So next question. The product of all prime numbers, number between 80 and 90 is option A. Option B. 89. Option C. 7387. Option D. 7200. Don't tell the answer. Rajwal, mute your audio. Rajwal, Chintan. Rajwal, Chintan, mute your audio. See, don't tell the answer. If you know, you can send message. You can send through the message. See, prime numbers between 80 and 90. So you know that 81 is not the prime number. It is divided by 9. 82 is not the prime number. Okay, so it is divided by 2 as well as it is going by 6. 82 is not a prime number. When you go for 83, so 83 is the prime number. It is not divided by any number if you want to take that. 1 is 83. 84 is not a prime number. 85 is not a prime number. 86 is not a prime number. 87 is also not a prime number because 87 is divided by 3. So it is going by 29 times. 29 threes are. Okay, 87 is not a prime number. 88 is not a prime number. 89 is a prime number. Only these two will come. 83 and 89. So the product of these two is what? Multiply and send the answer. Good, very good. Arsha, Prajwal, good. Multiply and send the answer. Sanjay, very good. Sanjay. Yashraj, good. Like this only. You should write, you should understand the statement. Question you should understand. According to that, you do the, you find the answer. Okay? This is only very important in multiple choice questions. You should understand the questions. Without understanding, don't do. Bhargav Ram, very good. Hitesh, good.
Sir, even I said, last time.
Okay. Yeah, who is that? You, Raja. Rohit, you are not sending. Answer. Bhargav Ram sent, Sanjay sent. They multiplied. Rohit, not sent. Multiply those two and send the answer. Sukshit is also not sending the answer. Why I am asking means you should be active to solve the MCQs. Okay? So multiply those two, you are getting 83 into 89 is equal to 7387. Option C is correct. At what time you have in classes in your school?
Sir, in my school I have from 8:30 to
8:30, yeah.
Still school not started, sir.
Not started, huh? For somebody you started, you know.
Sir, board blur.
Blur, huh? You multiply, man. Those two you multiply. Okay, I will change it. The problem, sir? The board blur, I know.
Sir, now it came. Now it came.
Okay. बोल सकता हूँ सर. Next question. Question number nine. Next. So you write the question. Which statement among? I will write on board. Like this only they will ask. This is also one type of question. Which statement among? The following is not true. Option A. Every natural number is an integer. You can call these are reasoning sums. We are going to solve as true and false, you know, like that. Reasoning sums. So these are also one type of sums in MCQs. Every natural number is a real number. Option C. Every real number. Is a rational number. Don't tell the answer. Every real number is a rational number. Option D. Every integer is a rational number. In this, you should pick up which is the wrong statement. So write the question. So you should find the answer. You should tell me in the next class. Don't tell now. Harsha, I am telling you, don't tell now. In next class, I am asking. Okay. You should tell the answer in next class. So you observe the number system, what I explained. You apply here. You find which is false statement.
Okay, sir. Sir,
your voice is not clear, huh?
Sir. How many questions are there still, sir?
So I told you, nearly 50 to 60 sums I will do.
Okay, sir.
Time is there. Don't worry, Arsha. Time is there. If you know how to do the rational numbers, then the other questions become easy.
Okay, sir. Okay.
We should tell answer for this in next class.
Yes, sir.
You right?
Yes, sir.
What is your doubt?
Sir, nothing.
Okay. So, thank you. So, I will continue in next class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, Prajwal. Asha, Bhargav Rao, Hitesh, Yashraj, Yuvraj. Thank you.
Bye, sir.
Bye, bye. Prajwal, Keshav Prajwal, thank you. Thank you.